I exist. I'm not down out of the count yet. I am still here. Oh no. I am here. I am still here. Oh no. So guys, hope you guys are having a wonderful morning, evening, or whatever time it is for you guys. I hope you're having a wonderful time of it all. But yeah, we are here. We are going to have fun. Yeah, I know I'm early because I have work today, Red. If I didn't have work, I wouldn't be so early. That is what I'll say. If I wasn't superbly early, well, you know, if I didn't have work, then I wouldn't be this early. But work exists for a reason, and I hate the reason why it exists sometimes. But, you know, it is what it is. We can't change it, so work. Certainly something. But yeah, I am early. Nice. Yeah, I don't get that luxury. Hello, Lowing Boy DK, how you doing? Hope you're having a wonderful day. I know that I am. We're gonna be playing the Ram. We're gonna be playing a bunch of different vehicles today, hopefully. It's only for an hour, and hour 15 today, because, you know, work exists, and you can't fight work because work exists. You see, I wasn't called in to work today. Ah, I see. All I'm gonna say is this. If work didn't call me in today, you know, I'd be able to stream for longer and later on. Ah, I'm doing great. I'm just making my way, trying to get tanks like the M50 and stuff. I don't really play too many other countries, but... And damn, Red, you freaking uppercutted the bitch, eh? That's good on you, buddy. But, yeah, I'm just making my way down the tree. Same with the aviation stuff. I'm just making my way down the tree. So, slowly but surely, I will say. Just making my way down the tree. Yep. And hey, that's fair enough. But yeah, so, we can do, like, lower BR for now, because those battles seem to be quicker for some fucking reason, I don't know why. But, yeah. I'm gonna recommend a tank for people to get. The M4A5, 90mm in front angle armor. Don't get hit on the side or you're dead, basically. If you get hit on the side, you're most likely dead. Hey, Red, how you doing?
I'm doing fine. How about you?
I'm doing great. Today and Friday are going to be a similar kind of setup, but tomorrow, Wednesday, and Thursday are going to be way different in terms of length.
Yeah?
Yeah. Because I don't have work Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday. I work again Friday and Saturday if all goes well. If not, then I'm back to Saturday, Sunday. Hey, that's all good. That's all good. We're just going to try some stuff, I guess. We're going to try the stuff. And we got fully upright, up tiered, I mean.
God damn it.
What point you going to? Spawn one or two?
One.
Alright. I'm gonna pop in the RAM and see what happens. Probably gonna get shot.
I'm just gonna use the M10.
You know, that's fair enough, but... Even at 4.7, I can bounce stuff in the RAM. It's not... A bad tank to bounce things in, but you know, even still, it's gonna be a hard time.
True, but it's not a really best one to use either at this battle rating.
Yeah, but even still.
Oh, we got a fireblind.
So 5.5 is going to be going for long range stuff. I can go medium to short range, but I can still pick stuff off long range style, so... Just give me the Panzer IVs. I'll take out Panzer IVs and stuff.
I know.
I guess the funny thing is, the amount of machine guns this thing has, it's more of an AP, like an armored personnel carrier than a tank. But the gun makes it what it is, because honestly, it's not a bad gun. You can still take down a lot of targets with it, just it's fun to attempt.
Oh yeah, if you wanna buy some American vehicles, you should wait till the 5th. They go on sale.
Alright. How much you want to bet there's about 3 enemies up on the, near the B point?
I'll tell you when I get shot at.
Ah, fair enough. What's our team? Oh, we're against Russia, Italy, and France, so watch out for ARLs then. Where was that from?
Right side. Is that?
Alright.
Just can't have anything nice anymore.
So I got shot from somewhere, but I can't really pinpoint location.
Yeah. Just spawning in.
Undamaged. Fuck. I'm not gonna push this.
Sure, you will be fine.
Critical hit causing a fire. Fire is healthy. Ah, the ram. Lovely vehicle.
It serves him right. We no longer have the advantage.
Enemy out.
Alright.
Vital.
Run there.
I right. Missed.
I'm just getting rocked by the RD, not even taking any major damage.
Got him.
Nice.
Oh, that's an ITP. That's serious, huh? Oh, that's the BT-5.
Alright.
It looks the same to me.
You can try to hit me all you want, buddy. You really aren't going to be going through this armor anytime soon.
Don't say that, you know.
I know, but I did.
But stop it.
It's a T-34! What's the worst that could happen?
You get fucked over by another T-34.
What's, Red, what's the worst that could happen if I face a T-34 again? And then watch me die by another, like, T-34 of some kind, like, across the fucking map and shit.
In a moment.
Oh, for sure. Fuck. It's like trying to... It's like a game of, like, spot that Alright, shot from this side. I'm backing up. That shit. M4 hybrid right across using the stairs in a building for cover. How much enemy air is there?
There's only one so far.
Alright. Well, I'm gonna risk it for a biscuit. I'm going the A20.
Who is going right for my... Come on.
If you can call out a couple enemies near B, I could drop bombs on their heads, but that is a major if.
I can try. Uh-oh, T-34. On the...
Yeah, I'm heading right for it. I'm gonna get ready to go into a dive. I'm basically firewalling my throttles.
The enemy is winning. We've got to counterattack. The enemy controls most of the strategic zones.
Alright, I'm coming in, Red. Get ready.
can't move.
I might have died, but I got the T-34.
Tired.
I forgot there was a thing called the ground for a second there.
That's another behind us.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to spawn in the ram. Because the only other aircraft I have doesn't have any bombs and would not be useful against anything at this BR. It'd be useful against stuff at 3.7, but not anything on the ground for this BR. If you're going in the air...
No.
Is that something over there?
I died to a Chinese. Fuck me.
I'm dropping artillery because there's enemy tanks. I'm approaching spawn from the C-point.
Got it.
The fun joys of this game. So I have no little turret now, so I'm gonna rely a lot more on my main gun and my actual turret, so that's a bit fucked, but that's okay. Well, yeah, it's still just my main gun turret.
T-34 rock down there.
Yeah. I'm getting on it.
Enemy on me.
Nothing sighting. No sighting. Shit. I'm basically gonna use my allies as shields here because I don't wanna get shot again, because if I do, I'm most likely dead.
Fair enough.
Basically, 2, 3, 4. Fucking hybrids. Alright. M4, go through that.
So many planes.
Yeah, don't worry, I already know that frontier. There's like, they're just spawn camping us like the little pussies that they are, so. That's the thing too, like, if I redesigned this game, no one would want to play it. Because of one reason, I'd make it balanced and fair, for the most part. Because like I'd basically put each nation into like a class system of all around, brawling, and sniping. You'd actually have one of each on each team, at least, and then everything else would basically just be whatever. Like Russia would be. Russia would be basically just like the brawling. Germany would just be a bit more of a sniping area. And America would just be all around. Britain would also be sniping. China, I guess they would be all around. France would be brawling, I guess. And then I don't know what else, but yeah.
They would be more scouting.
Well, with France, right, they have the heavy capabilities of, like, the ARL and the AMXs, right? Like, the later AMXs. So, like, they would be more of a brawling classification than an all-around or a sniping classification.
Behind us.
Where? Yeah, I see it. Look, that's the thing, like, I would make this game more fair for everybody. I'd also increase, like, how much research points you get from a battle, because, frankly, you don't get enough unless you do, like, super well in this game, right?
Yeah.
So, like, why not just make it fair and balanced, like, make it more interesting. Oh. And then, like, that's what I do for ground and stuff. Air would somewhat fall under the same category, like, well, more of just scouting air, more, like, more designed for scouting, more designed for strike, and then more designed for, fighters. Or all around, again. Like, here's the thing. America, if you look at America for their tanks, they have a healthy mixture of everything. You have your brawlers that can get up close and fight. You have your sniping vehicles that can do long range. And then you have your all-around that can do both. America is basically just, it can do both. Right? Germany is more of a brawler or a sniper. Well, actually, no. Germany's more of a sniper, I find, because the Tigers are really easy to take out. But they have a lot more long range than a lot of the other trees.
True.
Russia, they're more of a brawler. I will say that. They have stuff that can get you right up close and just take you out. And plus, the Russian bias is real, so. Britain, definitely more of a sniper. Japan, I'd also put them as a sniper. China, all around, I guess. Italy, sniping. France, brawler. Sweden, I would say sniping. And then Israel, brawler, I'd say. But that's just my honest opinion of it. Because there really ain't much to, you know, there ain't much to it. Because right now, the way that the game is focused, you have tanks that are not similar whatsoever working together, so why not make it so that one group of tanks, which is more designed to do this, gets put on a team of tanks that is, like, all around and designed to go into cities and take things out. It would make it more balanced and more fun, plus the increase of research points would definitely be a welcome thing, I think.
Yeah.
Like, base for one kill is 1,000 research points. That's what I'm thinking. Because right now I have no idea what it is.
That does sound fair.
And I'm just thinking, like, not even just for, like, the experienced players, because the experienced players are going to like this game probably regardless. Right? And I'm thinking of, like, the new people coming in, you know?
Yeah.
And plus, then I'd also add Poland. I would add Poland and I'd make them an all-arounder. Because that's really what they are. Poland is an all-arounder. Because, like, with Germany as range, right, which, frankly, they do have a lot of good ranged weaponry, because they're 88s, right? If you take into account the 88s and all that, then, hands down, Germany is just straight-up range. America's all around. Poland, I think they'd be all around, too, and Jesus Christ, not again. Well, back to the RAM. I'm just thinking off the top of my head, though, like, the way the game is right now makes sense, but why not make it more interesting and fun for people, not just, you know, stuffing a bunch of different teams, like, nations on the same team without, like, some reason, because I've had a game where it was just America and Russia versus everybody. Yeah, sure, America can pick up the slack for range.
Yeah, in what universe is that gonna happen?
But the thing is, too, like, Germany, right? Having Germany on your team, you don't have to worry as much about range.
But you also have to think about the player base.
Well, that's the thing, too. I think there should be some way of, like, determining, like, not rank per se, but, like, what skill you are based on your averages and stuff, right? Like, if you get 2 to 3 kills a match, you're going to play with people who also get 2 to 3 kills a match. or if you're like constantly getting like top 10 on your top 5 on your team, you're gonna play with people who are also top 5 on your team. Like, it's not gonna be what it used to be. But that's just my honest opinion what it should be, but, you know. What? Already, someone shot you in the back? Let me see it. Oh, fucking Jesus. Don't complain about that little thing.
I'm using a German tank. I'm allowed to complain.
Well, then use it as a range. You use the power of the range that thing has. And I can basically just be on the front.
Gonna look at the fucking cone speed it got with the turret.
Yeah, yeah. That's why you're a sniping vehicle. I'm on the front.
Oh, it's because it's a premium.
I thought that M19 was an enemy tank for a second. I just saw the tracks around. I'm like, alright, I'm ready to shoot it. Where is it? That's how easy it is in this game to, like, get freaked out, though, too, right? Like, any little movement can set you off and end up... If you're in simulation, you can end up killing an ally because of it. You know, the enemies would... Like, the enemies should come up this road, you know? They should, but they don't. Well, they aren't. At least I can tell they aren't, but... We have two Panzer IV.
Something ahead. Right there.
Critical hit on a Sark. Yep, there's multis. Here, aren't I? Oh, I'm definitely fucked! Unless I can take out this guy's gun. Or I can just bounce every shell that comes my way. One of the two. Alright, T-34. How you doing? Critical hit. Hello again, Jesus fuck.
I'm so fucking confused how the fuck they got me.
Oh my god. I'm taking like 100% of the shells here.
Hey, you continue to do that, because I can't take a single shell without dying.
I could really use help. Without traversing my turret, I even did so much damage. I wish you could tell the team, like, they're all right there, do something, but no, they get mad at you, be like, hoi, hoi, hoi. Yes. Alright, you took my gun. My turret's repaired, though. I think. There you go, you finally killed me, you dumbasses. They finally killed me, Red. They actually got me for once. I'm going back in there and I'm gonna take the rest of them out. I'm gonna take them by their knees. But, like, yeah, you see what I mean? Like, the Ram can take a punishment. Like, the Ram can take punishment and a half. But, like, you honestly need someone else to support. Like, as, like, a supporting tank, because if you don't, you're fucked. Even another Ram would be a good supporting tank, too, but... And you're in the Warble Wind, okay. Just go on the sides of them, see, just murder them all.
I did something dumb.
What'd you do?
I sent a picture of the tank that killed me. To a channel, but it was the wrong channel. it on a like the right channel button, not this time.
Jeez. Why was this though? The ram must be infuriating for people who go against it if they don't one-shot it, and it takes them forever to kill, and they're just like, how? This thing must be one of the most infuriating vehicles in the game.
Oh, come on!
I mean, you could do what the Canadians did with the skink and just use yourself as a ground attack vehicle.
No, I don't like doing that.
Nah, dude, you're playing the Warblewind. Everyone will hate you anyway. Nah, we're playing against the enemy. You gotta take sacrifices, Red. Sacrifices must be made. How much you want to bet I'm gonna get one shot here next time I go around this area?
No, I don't want to do it.
No, I didn't get one shot, but I can't get the freaking KV-85 right there.
Do you have ammo?
Yeah, but it has an 85 that can yeet through my armor.
That fucking name is a me Mario. Fucking fantastic.
It's falling back. Can someone actually do something to that KV? Cause like, you know, I can't take the punishment forever from that thing.
Ah, fuck it. It seems we missed. In my sucker. On target. I ran out of ammo. What was I doing? Oh, yes. In my sucker.
Clicking simulator 2022. Damn it, your gun, damn you!
Can you hit the other properly? Michelle hasn't done
any damage! Give me your gun! Fine, I'll push up in a Oh, I'm stuck on a building. You'll love to see it.
He's fucking stuck.
Critical hitted.
Right.
Alright, that's 185 down. And the second one got me. God fucking damn it. Alright, I'm going in for a bomber now. I ain't messing around anymore, little small man.
I'm taking off my pants.
Now this time I'm gonna remember that the ground exists. Hopefully.
Say so.
There's a lot of enemy tanks that need to be shot by bombs.
I don't know.
Probably their spawn, right?
No.
No? Surprisingly not.
Keep it up and victory will be ours.
Deducing where this guy is not going to be overtly hard. Pitch straight up. I'm just gonna make a pump out to the airport, if you get what I'm saying.
I can't hit it.
Need cover. Affirmative. Guide on me. Cover me.
Come on, Big Bertha, bring yourself around here. You know, it's funny, I had to turn around and just go help that one guy. Now I'm gonna make my way back to base and hope there's no enemy air behind me. Start throttling back, I guess. I'll put it at 15, no, I'll put it at 65. Combat flaps are out.
There's an angry heavy tank.
I have no bombs.
Oh, I got it.
Nice.
I didn't mean to kill it.
Well, you killed it.
Yeah, single shot.
One shot, one kill. That's
yeah.
All you need.
I don't know how to fucking get it.
I'm coming in for a nice smooth landing, I think. Just nice and smooth. I hope.
If you say so.
Brakes are armed.
I do your love best.
And braked.
Thanks. A little more effort and victory will be ours.
Oh, never mind, I'm good.
Yeah, well, I'm pretty good at drifting my planes. And I'm just blocking off the whole runway. Oh, I'm gonna have to do a wheelie out of here, aren't I, too? Fuck. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna burn some wheelie. Come on. Yeah, wheelie. I'm doing a wheelie.
Oh, nice.
For now. Watch it drop down to 5th by the end of the game. Well, that's the thing too, like, I'm really good at lower BRs, but like at topper, like at higher BRs, people are like near the same skill, like level, I guess. as like we usually are, it becomes more interesting, you know? And by far, I'm not saying like I'm good or I'm like the best of the game. By far, I'm not even saying that at all. I'm just saying, when I'm at higher BRs, the skill difference between me and the me and the other team are a lot more similar than you might think. But at lower BRs, I do really good because there is like a bit of a skill difference or skill gap compared to me and the people who are playing down here. As a lot of people who are playing down here are new, right?
Yeah.
But there's also that not the rare chance, but there is also the chance that you come across someone who's around your skill level, and then you get into a heated duel, and it becomes very interesting.
Yeah, that's true.
And that's one thing I like about 3.7. You can come across those people who are at around your skill level, and then it becomes super fun and challenging because you're both around the same skill level, and you're just like, oh boy, we're gonna have a heated duel today, boys. Like, it becomes like that.
Yeah, but then someone else comes over and fuck you over.
And that's the thing, like, a lot of people respect the 1v1 shit. Also, there's no tanks over here, god damn it, I thought there was. Oh well. Pull up, go around. Yeah. We also have the whole enemy team on B. Oh yeah, you're in the air too. Shit, I don't have any ground calls besides what I can make out. And because it's a city, I'm a little bit for that, but that's fine. Okay. Oh, I got enemy call out for spawn, looks like. Okay. Got him!
Ha! That's the dude I just killed.
Yeah, I've gotten a bit more accurate with my bombs now too, and my maneuverability with this big bertha of a vehicle is very simple. Firewall the throttles till your engines start dying, and then you throttle them off.
No more plane.
Oh, they have no more tanks. I killed the last guy.
Oh, wow.
I killed the last guy. That is so rare. That is so rare that you actually kill the last guy, you know? You love to see it.